they've been trying to keep her around as best as they can, but it's been kind of awkward considering the fact that she hasn't gotten in the ring. If that is indeed the case, I do understand. She has gotten a little bit physical, but I also, if she's even at like 95% and she'll be 100% at Double or Nothing, why are you fucking risking it? You invested way too much money in her, no pun intended, to have her, you know, re-aggravate her injury before, you know, she even has her big match on a pay-per-view. So, absolutely not worth it. And you know what I'm saying, you got to ride the Swerve, at least for now. And exactly, Swerve is red hot right now. If there's a reason they put the strap on him, send him to the moon and let it keep going. Okay, next up, we come to the Casino Gauntlet match. This was nuts. This is my favorite thing of the card. It was a little confusing at first, but once I understood what was going on, I loved it. So, here's the breakdown. The winner gets a shot at Roderick Strong and the International Championship at Double or Nothing. So, you start with two guys in the ring, and then the next guy comes to the ring after an interval of time. So it kind of creates like a Royal Rumble slash gauntlet match situation. But whoever gets the initial pinfall, or I guess submission, they didn't mention that, but whoever gets the first pinfall, no matter who is in the ring, what time it is, if everyone came out or not, they win. It can happen in the first 2 minutes. It can happen in the first 2 hours. It doesn't matter. It was chaos. It was awesome. I loved it. I absolutely loved it. Chris also jumping in with a cool stat really quick. Anna wrestled her 100th match in AEW tonight. That's really cool. I did not know that. Perfect place for her to do it. Obviously, you know, everything that happened with her and the Dark Order and Brody Lee. Jesus, $2 in Daly's place. I think that was actually pretty fitting for that to happen there. That's really cool. This match I absolutely loved. So we started off with Switchblade Jay White and Dante Martin. That was followed by Penta El Cerro Miedo, Kyle O'Reilly, and then holy fucking shit, Will Ospreay joined, followed by Lance Archer, Commander, and Jay Lethal.